Now we're back. Anyway.
I actually want
to look up that TV trope of what do you mean it wasn't made on drugs, just to see some of the examples. And again, I won't just blandly read through the list.
Compared to how you relatively read through the rest, you read through it fine.
No, I'm kind of calling out someone whose name rhymes with save.
Cave?
Close enough.
Shave?
Close.
Dave?
There you go.
I say that because he looks like he's a caveman that needs a shave.
I think he shaved recently. I also call him out because, I mean, the one video and beyond where he was reading that list of improvised movie quotes, I mean, you know I was already frustrated enough, but I think what made it worse for me is that he was basically just reading every part of it word for word really blandly.
He has no fun with what he does.
Okay, so these are some of the examples of games that fall into the... What do you mean it wasn't made on drugs?
What do you mean the bank's out of money? It's a Simpsons quote that you made me think of. Thanks, Matt. Asshole.
You're welcome.
I thought we were done with the Simpsons in this channel.
Oh, you brought up the quote.
You made me think of it.
Don't blame me.
I blame you.
Don't.
I do.
Stab.
No, I will not stab. I will go.
Okay, anyway. So they, of course, mentioned Super Mario Brothers.
Why?
It started as a humble platformer back in the 80s that featured the main character consuming mushrooms, whereupon he would immediately believe that he grew as tall as Alice. Or if it was a green mushroom, he would be revived upon death. He would take frequent trips through pipes, collect leaves that created smoke that would give him a magic tanuki costume. There was the surreal imagery of winged turtles, turtles flying on clouds, walking mushrooms with angry faces, mushrooms, stars, clouds, hills, and everything having a face, and communism. Well, that wasn't
what
actually
what is with the communist theory of Mario Brothers? I don't get it.
Well, whatever. That's irrelevant. Mario and Luigi Bowser's Inside Story also has segments where Bowser is nearly crushed by his stolen castle and is saved by Mario and Luigi during an overhead shooter minigame that gives him an adrenaline rush that makes him grow giant, where he does things like fight his own castle with said castle flying around on a rocket. And then there's Fawful's dialogue that apparently never makes sense. I wouldn't know because I didn't play Bowser's Inside Story.
I know who Fawful is, but I never seen any of his dialogue.
Well, I'm gonna be like the joking advertising guy. You can learn later this year when Mario and Luigi Bowser's Inside Story comes to the Nintendo 3DS.
Yeah, and not Partners in Time for some reason.
And Ubisoft even kicks the acid trip to a new high with Mario and Rabbids Kingdom Battle. That's already a crazy idea because who thinks to put those characters into a frickin' tactical RPG? But in the game, there's a selfie-snapping Rabbid Peach, a giant toilet with a spike-collared duck, and a Rabbid Donkey Kong. Or Rabbid Kong. Totally sounds druggy. Apparently there was an Aqua Teen Hunger Force golf video game.
Excuse me?
And the TV Tropes page says, if there wasn't drug use involved in the production of the game, someone has to be given a stylish canvas blazer with sleeves that do up at the back. Some people may have heard of this game, but Bait and Kaidos?
I think I have.
Because they say that after going through a trippy psychedelic trail of souls, you'll end up in a place with candy towns and a picture book city that kind of looks like Paper Mario. And just from looking at the cover of the game, Bait and Kaidos isn't one of those kind of games.
What's the cover look like?
I'll show you the cover of the GameCube one, Bait and Kaidos Origin. Or, there's two GameCube ones. I'll just look up Bait and Kaidos for you. That's the original, and then this is Origins.
Are you gonna edit it into the video so people can see it or no?
They got the internet.
Y'all ain't lazy.
Yeah, because I was going to say, like, if I say they can look it up themselves, and you say, what if they can't? Mike, if they're on the internet watching this video, how can they not?
Because everybody's as lazy as me.
Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg. Children in chicken suits beat up crows with eggs.
Yeah. Also, the theme song.
G-I-N-T-E-G-G.
Mmm, that's some good Giant Egg.
Bit Trip?
Never heard of it.
I've heard of this one. It's very trippy. Brutal Legend?
Yeah.
You defeat enemies with the power of rock!
As Jack Black.
And, you face off against antagonists directly inspired by contemporary music styles, such as groups of pale, mascara-stained goth girls. My.
And your main villain is Tim Curry.
Yeah. Conker's Bad Fur Day.
Yeah.
Just take Banjo-Kazooie, which you could already apply this trope to, with imagery that looks like it came out of Looney Tunes, add in a bunch of gore references and bodily functions.
Boom!
That too. This one, I mean, if you didn't think this was a like a what do you mean it wasn't made on drugs game, you're missing the point. Cuphead.
Yeah.
Because that game has this the animation style that fits perfectly into this trope.
Well, Cuphead and his power man, they like to roll the...
Stop tripping me out!
Are you gonna punch me?
Maybe.
See, I'm not the abusive one here.
Oh,
I only
shut
fight
up.
Back to protect myself.
You do not fight back to protect yourself. You're the one that throws the first punch.
Save me!
Save the orphans.
Whoa.
Save the orphans.
Buy two, get one free.
Save the orphans.
Hey, that guy over there can't adopt them all.
Save the orphans.
Burger King.
Hash browns.
Burger King.
Coffee.
Burger King.
French fries.
Burger King.
Breakfast.
Shout out to Ashiba.
They mentioned Donkey Kong Country as an example of, what do you mean it wasn't made on drugs?
Is it because he wears a tie?
Part of it, yeah. You play as a gorilla in a tie trying to get back a horde of bananas that were stolen by an army of anthropomorphic crocodiles, whose ranks also include giant hornets covered in spikes, the giant oil drum boss, Donkey Kong 64 had bosses that include a giant armadillo the size of a whale with a metal shell and two cannons that shoot fireballs, a fire-breathing dragonfly lizard thingy, and giant fire-breathing pufferfish. And Donkey Kong Country Returns apparently has tikis that mind-control animals with music.
Yeah.
My. Earthbound is definitely a trippy. I haven't even played the game that much, but I know that it's a trippy-ass game.
I haven't played much either, but I can believe you. Yep.
Final Fantasy XV's Mystery Disc.
Huh?
It's a special build of the game that was made exclusively for the pre-release party the day before the game launched. The highlights include Noctis traveling to a Final Fantasy XV Eve festival with real fan art decorating the walls, Prompto becoming a supersized version of his grade school self, Noctis destroying oversized snacks to prevent Prompto from eating them, and a boss battle with the CEO of Square Enix.
I feel like that was made up.
Apparently it's a real thing.
I won't believe it until I see it.
I'm gonna look it up now. Final Fantasy XV Mystery Disc.
Is it sad when the shooter just bores the shit out of me?
There's gameplay of it.
Wow. Okay, we don't have to watch it now. Just finish your list so we can talk about other stuff.
No shit. Anything that's made by Suda51.
Yeah.
They even say that apparently the cover of Shadow of the Shadows of the Damned explicitly calls it a Suda 51 trip.
I wouldn't know because I have the pre-owned GameStop bag.
Come on.
You know those fake cases that they that GameStop puts their games in when they don't have the actual case?
Wait, we own Shadow of the Damned?
Yeah, it's in my closet.
Really now? I didn't even know this.
You want to play it at some point?
No.
I don't think it's bad.
Well, it's not my kind of game.
I didn't know until you tried.
I've heard bad things.
Matt, does plus, not like, Matt confirmed to not like bad games.
Does anyone? And plus, I was going to say, Suda51's games usually don't even do much for me.
You've played how many Suda games again?
I'm just looking at them, I mean. Like, I've watched you play No More Heroes, and it just doesn't do a lot for me. Anyway, they mentioned Kingdom Hearts on here, so I was correct in saying that that was a drug trip.
Oh, yeah.
They say that the trope is subverted with the game Golden Sun Dark Dawn. That was, like, the DS one. Because the creators actually admitted that they were drunk when they came up with the idea to make a new game in the series. Nice. By the way, Isaac First Smash. Zelda. Where the hell do we begin? The CDI games, Majora's Mask, and Link's Awakening are the main examples.
Yeah, baby.
I actually can't even read a lot of what they say about Majora's Mask and Link's Awakening because a lot of it's blurred out for spoilers.
Which is a good thing, but still.
Apparently, they say even Need for Speed is not safe because in the 2012 Need for Speed Most Wanted game, because you know there's two of them.
Yeah.
There's ambush event cinematics, and they kind of show what driving under the influence looks like. Hmm. The perfect example.
I love going berserk.
Nicktoons MLB.
Yeah.
Apparently, a lot of the previews and reviews actually inform the readers and audience.
That it is indeed real.
That it's not a joke and that they're not seeing things. And apparently Giant Bomb did like a quick look at video edit, and one of the guys said that when he saw it at E3, he was questioning his sanity.
Rather insanity.
Parappa the Rapper, yeah. That definitely seems like one.
Well, you gotta sing to do everything, so yeah, baby.
Pokemon. They mentioned specifically Heart Gold and Soul Silver. The Kimono Girls. And they mentioned that Gen 7 seems to be taking Heart Gold and Soul Silver's crown as the weirdest main series games.
Oh, yeah. Gen 7 was a weird game.
I can imagine. Psychonauts. Having played a little bit of it, absolutely.
It's like a Tim Burton movie. On drugs and something crazy is always happening.
It's the same... Isn't it the same guy that made Brutal Legend?
Yeah, Double Fine.
Tim Schafer?
Double Fine. I know it's the company. I don't know if it was the guy.
Tim Schafer is the name. Rayman.
Yeah.
Rayman Origins.
Yeah.
Samba de Amigo. The Sega game? With the monkey?
Yeah.
They say not so much the concept, but more like the backgrounds being psychedelic and trippy.
Oh, that was a level.
Yay. See, how far are we? 14 minutes, we got time.
Oh, I think this is the boss level, the Necropolis.
The Necropolis. Is that someone's neck?
I don't know.
They mentioned quite a few Sonic games. The original Genesis games, Sonic Colors and Sonic Shuffle.
Okay.
Toe Jam and Earl. Absolutely, I've played the first one.
I've seen all the Toe Jam and Earl games.
And the last one worth noting was Yoshi's Island.
Really?
Touch Fuzzy, Get Dizzy.
Ah, this is truly a bizarre universe.
It says the bizarre drug-like distortion of the level, map, and the background music is creepy, and it's bizarre in real life, too.
Ain't that the God's honest truth?
I'm not gonna watch it, but they have a video where it says
some incubus with the pistol killed two, kind of even my show.
Yeah. All right. Anyway, continuing.
Yeah, they had a video called "Live Action Touch Fuzzy Get Dizzy." I mean, honestly, when I think of freaking Yoshi's Island and I think of Trippy, you know what I'm thinking.
What?
That commercial.
That commercial wasn't Trippy, it was disgusting.
But it had to have been made on drugs.
Oh yeah. Some guy just gorging on food till he fucking explodes.
No sane person was like, yeah, let's do that.
I don't even know how that got past the censors.
Don't ask me, I wasn't alive at the time. You know what I recently found out, since we were mentioning like the whole what do you mean it wasn't made on drugs thing? I think I actually heard that Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles were actually created because the people that made the characters were on drugs, and they said, what if we made turtles that, like, did kung fu and ate pizza?
Actually, here's the thing. When the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles debuted in the comic books, they actually weren't pizza lovers. In fact, it was extremely serious. It was only until the cartoon that they started eating the pizza.
But still, the point is, the people that made Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, from what I heard, I think they actually were high, and they were legitimately just like, what if we made turtles that did, like, kung fu and shit?
And actually were different from each other instead of just being the same person wearing a gray bandana. Yeah, because when they debuted, they all had the same color bandana. They weren't different colors. Hmm.
Well, go them, I guess.
Yeah. So I'm like, which one's Raphael again? I am. No, the one with the size. Then someone punches the guy in the face and takes a size. I am.
No, it's me, it's me! You guys aren't making this easy. Kind of like the Toy Story 2 scene. So, I'm Buzz Lightyear, and I'm in charge of this. No, I'm Buzz Lightyear. I'm Buzz Lightyear.
So, who's the real Buzz?
I am!
Don't let this imposter fool you! He's been trained by Zurg to mimic my every move!
You know that part when he does the... I always thought he said, I like. I was like, you like what? Choking to death?
I don't know. Then he just shows him the boot. Buzz! And it was you, Buzz, the whole time. My back end just had to catch up on my front end.
What does that even mean? Actually, it does make sense because earlier in the movie, who's behind? Mine.
I did like the voice actor they got for Slinky in 3. He sounded just like the original guy.
Yeah. I mean, I point out that apparently they were like best friends in real life, and even though there is the logic of just because you're best friends doesn't mean you sound alike, when you're best friends with Jim Varney, I feel like, especially if you're a voice actor or an actor of any kind, if you're best friends with Jim Varney, you pick up on his accent.
Yeah.
Because I imagine if he talked like that in real life, you'd probably pick up on it pretty quick. The video game for that, I mean, we already let's played it on Dave's channel, but that was a good video game as well.
Oh god, Toy Story 2 was a great game.
One of the better license-based video games. I say most because I could pick apart a few prime examples, but most Pixar games actually aren't too bad.
They really aren't. Because we got assholes who don't want to like anything kid-related, because, oh, it's kiddie.
There's that, but just if we disregard that, there's... most of the Pixar games are pretty good. I think the ones that really aren't are, like, Finding Nemo, Wall-E.
I've never played the Finding Nemo game.
I played it once, because we rented it from Blockbuster.
Stop making me sad.
I miss them too.
I'm gonna miss Toys R Us too, they're closing in 8 days. And they're selling shelves.
Point is, I remember renting it and not really liking it. The Wally game was not very good. And then I think I heard Brave wasn't very good at a game.
Brave was also only on Xbox, right? It had the Kinect
motion. I think it was also on the PlayStation. Hold on. This time I'm not going to use my laptop, I'm going to use my phone because it was right next to me. Let's rock a wiki. But other than that, there's a lot of other pretty solid Pixar games.
Monster Inc. Scream Team was pretty good.
Yeah, Scream Team was good. Yeah, no, it was actually... Brave was on PC and Mac. It was on DS, PS3, Wii, and 360.
360 was the one with the Kinect.
Yes. I want to say that...
No, I want to say you were required to use the Kinect.
It wasn't required. It just says it's better with it.
But yeah, no, it wasn't.
But that's what all the cases that are Kinect games say. Because they like to trick you.
Are there any Kinect games out now?
Just Dance 2019 is coming to the Xbox 360 and the Wii.
What do you mean you ran out of ideas? Fuck you!
But yeah, point is, A Bug's Life was good, Toy Story 2 was good, Scream Team was good. I think I've heard people say the Incredibles game was pretty good.
I played it for a little while. The only problem with it was there's no two-player.
Yeah, that does suck.
Especially with a game like this, where you can be Mr. Incredible, Elastigirl,
Dash, Violet.
The Dash Sexons were horrible.
Frozone.
The Dash Sexons were horrible.
I didn't play the game today. Most of the Cars games are good, though, because, like, I mean,
It's kart racers.
It's Cars. I played a little bit of the Ratatouille game.
I didn't hate it.
It wasn't bad. I heard mixed things about the Up game, but for the most part, I heard it was, like, alright.
Let me tell you, as a guy who actually played and beat the Up game, I think it was good for little kids.
Yeah. And then I heard that, well, not that I heard, I played it. Toy Story 3, the game, was quite good.
Yeah. Even the multiplayer and the single player. And if the multiplayer and the story mode was a little haphazard. Because it didn't know whether or not it wanted to be split screen or both screens.
Yeah, that's true. But, yeah, that was a good game. I heard that the Cars 2 game was quite good.
Yeah, because Cars 2 just did exactly what Cars 1 did, only better.
Yeah, it refined things, and I think it gave it more content, too.
That's kind of the thing with all the Cars games, honestly. It's not really hard to make a Cars game. Especially since they've done it multiple times, not just based around the movies.
Well, I mean, because they're also racing games. I'm not saying all racing games are easy to make, but I feel like making a racing game, like a game based on Cars, is probably a bit easier than some of the other Pixar games.
Probably.
Like, I feel like I think of Cars, and I imagine that doing better as a video game than something like Up would. Because even though Up, like, even though I've heard it was a decent game, that's not something that, like, that's not a story that I can ideally see as a video game.
Same with Coco.
Yeah, and that's why Coco wasn't a video game.
I think Coco's the only Pixar movie that never got a game.
No, because after Brave, they stopped releasing console games for Pixar.
No, because here's the thing. Inside Out and The Good Dinosaur got toys in
Disney Infinity. Doesn't count.
They still got a game.
Doesn't count.
They got a game.
Doesn't count.
But then again, though, what could you do with Coco in a video game?
You shoehorn in a music game.
Even though it's not the music they gotta worry about.
Yeah, it's really... The movie's more about family and culture, but I feel like given how people shoehorn shit... Like, especially, like, when you're making a licensed game. I feel like for some reason it would just be a haphazard music game.
Probably.
It would be some Guitar Hero clone without a guitar controller. So you'd have to play the guitar, but with the buttons on a regular controller.
Eh. We'll make millions! Then we see the reviews. Yeah, millions of failures.
We'll make millions! No, because we're all gonna ask for refunds. Oh, damn, we're 24 minutes.
Here. Let's pause right here, then. Middle of this fight.
Okay.